So I'm not going to talk to you about gamification because I think that might be one of the other speakers, but that'll be fine. We'll come to that. So what I'm going to speak to you about today is what we've done at AstraZeneca around a particular leader development experience called Leading Business that we've been working with Duke on. And I want to share that story with you because it gives a really nice example, I think, of how you can bring together humanity and technology. But a little bit first of all about, I need my clicker, a little bit first of all about AstraZeneca, just for those of you that aren't familiar with the organisation. We are a global pharmaceutical business headquartered in Cambridge with two other key sites in Sweden and the US, centred around science. 65,000 employees globally, three key therapeutic areas, oncology, cardiovascular, renal, and metabolic, which is heart disease and diabetes, and respiratory, which includes asthma. In Africa, we're here in South Africa, plus three other key areas. And we're passionate about access. I think Mike mentioned access to patients and Roche. We're passionate about access and our patient-centric sustainability programs, particularly, for example, Healthy Heart Africa, which is an access program where we're targeting getting education and diagnostics and testing and treatment to 10 million people in Africa by 2025 to treat heart disease. So that's a little bit about AstraZeneca. We set about looking at our leader development experiences, and Leading Business is one of our key experiences that we introduced about a year ago. And it's designed to help leaders think differently about how they lead for the future. And these are some of the drivers that I have here that are shaping our organization. So we set about working with Duke to develop a really unique, if any of you have worked with Duke, you'll know they bring a really great perspective and experiential learning. So we designed Leading Business with Duke in partnership. The design for Leading Business is we're targeting 1,500 leaders globally. It's a 3 to 4 month learning experience, and we have 100 people in each cohort. And that's deliberate because it's designed to reach scale and also to create the opportunity to create a network within the organization. We have a couple of people here who are actually part of our Leading Business cohort today from AstraZeneca. The key themes you can see there on the right-hand side. But what I wanted to draw your attention to is the design. So this is a blended design. Two virtual terms using social online learning centered around a live 3-day learning experience, experiential, immersive in our headquarters in Cambridge. And also we leverage our social platform internally, Workplace, to just give a little bit more flexibility to how people can interact. Now, this design was not grasped with open arms by the business. We were challenged on this, on two things. One was you can't engage people around leadership in cohorts of 100 people. They need to be in smaller groups because people like to learn in discussion with other people. And also, secondly, you can't develop leadership behaviors through technology, by using learning technology. That's not how you can get to leadership behaviors. And I think this comes from a place where we have a view of learning being very human-centric. It's about us as people, and preferably with other people, sharing ideas, learning and discussing, maybe in a room face-to-face. And using learning technology is something that you keep for compliance. That's something that you do if you have to do. But what we've seen through Leading Business is something very different emerge. So Leading Business now is being delivered for 9 months. We've just launched cohort 5. And what we see emerging is this really rich learning ecosystem. You've got the live event, you've got the learning platform, also accessible on mobile. We have the opportunity to create a great global network because these are groups of 100 people, so this works really well for connecting people across the organization globally. People aren't all learning as a whole group of 100. They're divided into pods, small groups, 10 or 12 people in a group. What's really key, though, that we found makes the absolute difference to all these elements coming together and amplifying each other is here in the center, which is the coaches. So we have this digital platform. We also have the live event and we have coaches. And the coaches are connecting through the platform. So social online learning, people are in discussion. So the platform has, you'll be familiar with this if you have this in your own organizations, you'll have a learning resource. It might be a video. We pose a question and people get into discussion around that question. And the role of the coaches is engagement. So they are in there, in the platform, encouraging people, commenting, nudging people to stay engaged and stay involved, challenge people's thinking. And they do that on the workplace group as well in a slightly more informal way. And the coaches are not who you typically might think of as having in your learning program. We deliberately selected young people, young coaches, who are very tech savvy, social media savvy, and who can bring, they bring great energy and really kind of a real dynamic environment within the groups that they work with. So that the coaches have been absolutely fantastic at engaging our learners. And how do we know? Well, of course, because we're delivering this on a platform, we have data. So background analytics, platform analytics, we can look real time at what is happening at any point with any particular cohort. Are people progressing, aren't they? And then we let the coaches know. And the coaches and the program organizers provide nudges to remind targeted people about where they are in the program, and we can do that on a daily basis, so we're looking at this data real time. We pull that data through into dashboards that we can share with key business stakeholders. What we're also able to do is to use the data in the platform to say, let's actually understand if people are making comments on the platform, then in a social online learning environment, you know comments matter. The more quality the comments are, the more likely you're going to have that learning is happening. And that quality is about, am I building on what's in the learning resource, and am I talking about how I'm applying my learning? And we put in, with a platform provider, we've developed a piece of machine learning that that rates the comments that people are making. It gives a quality rating. So what we can now do is we can look at individual pieces of learning in the platform, individual resources, and say, is that video generating good quality comments or not? And if not, then what do we do about it? We can also look at by day, this is by day, as you go through a cohort, why was there that spike in quality of comments? What drove that? What happened? Let's talk to the coaches, find out what was going on in their pods, in their groups, that meant that there was that spike. Because how can we replicate that to create more engagement? And also, the purple dots here are people. We can look at individuals and also see who are the stars. So people gain points. We do have a gamification in the way that you would expect. People can rise up the leaderboard. But what this is doing is looking at the number of comments you make against the quality of the comments that you make. And what we know from this is quantity doesn't mean quality. So you can be at the top of the leaderboard. It doesn't mean that the comments that you're making are actually high quality comments. And this again is where our coaches come in. So we can recognize star people at the top of the leaderboard, but what we go to are our coaches and say, who do you see in the platform with the discussion, with the engagement, and the phone calls, the virtual calls, where they also have two during the course of, four during the course of the whole program. So who are the pods who are really outperforming others? And they give us the information with the data that we have in the platform to say, these are the star pods. We award a yellow jersey, which we award at the end of each stage. And they get, there's also a yellow jersey for the top pod at the end of the whole learning experience. But we also look at individuals, and the coaches will also get together and say, who are the individuals that really stood out? And the individuals that really stood out, the one person at the end of every cohort gets a pair of leading business trainers. These are high currency in AstraZeneca. They'll have your number of your cohort on the back, and there's only one pair. You know, go faster, keep on track, and keep up your pace. And so I think this whole, what I wanted to share with you in this short story was an example of how we're bringing together humanity and technology in a really dynamic learning ecosystem. Thank you.